Hello everyone, I am Dr. Anupam here. In our Ventilator Masterclass lecture series, today we will discuss about PRVC, otherwise called as Pressure Regulated Volume Control. As the name suggests, it is an adaptive mode of ventilation. Why it is adaptive? Because the ventilator adjusts itself to the changing respiratory mechanics. We will see how it will do that. So it is an advanced mode of ventilator. Let us discuss. It is otherwise also called VC plus, PCCMB, adaptive modes, depending upon the manufacturer. But the basic concept remains the same. What is the basic concept? I see it as a symphony or synthesis of volume control ventilation and pressure control ventilation, whereby taking the best of these two modes of ventilation while avoiding the worst. How? Let us discuss. If we divide into two parts, one is VCV, one is PCV. So what is the advantage of VCV? If we see, the advantage of VCV is we ensure a guaranteed minimum ventilation, right? So this is one of the advantage of VCV, one of the major advantages. We guarantee a minimum ventilation. What is the advantage of PCV? If we discuss PCV, we maintain the airway pressure at a certain limit for a certain period of time. So you do not go beyond the pressure. So it avoids barotrauma. Right? Which was a complication of VCV. Because VCV, because you're ensuring a good minute ventilation, it can produce barotrauma. Secondly, what is the advantage of PCV? Flow is not limited. The reason why if demand increases, if lung respiratory mechanics increases, the flow can be changed here, but not in volume control ventilation. So these are the disadvantage of volume control ventilation, but the advantage of pressure control ventilation. Third, increase in mean airway pressure, which was not the case when you were discussing VCV. And it will also provide constant and sustained pressure, right? So these are the advantages of PCV. And what is the disadvantage of PCV? It does not guarantee a minute ventilation, constant minute ventilation. Okay. So we consider this is disadvantage of PCV and this is disadvantage of VCV, right? So if you combine these two things, then this is called PRVC. So PRVC will provide a guaranteed minute ventilation. At the same time, it will provide the benefit of a pressure controlled breath, as you have discussed here, right? So now we have discussed what it is. Now we'll discuss how it is done, right? Discuss how to do it. The step one is calculate the compliance. Then step two will be calculate the pressure level to achieve the target minute ventilation, right? So in the beginning, if you consider the graphics of PRVC, So the initial breath will be a volume control breath with the inspiratory pause, so that you can calculate the plateau pressure. And we have the volume target, we have the plateau pressure. Now we have the compliance. Now based on that compliance, the ventilator will find an inspiratory pressure which can achieve our desired tidal volume. So first breath will be, a volume controlled breath. So this is a volume VC breath, right? And from this VC breath, we'll find this P plat. And using these both factor, we'll find out the compliance. And based on this compliance, the ventilator will calculate the inspiratory pressure level to achieve our desired mid ventilation. So from the next breath, it will be pressure controlled breaths. Now I have shown you that this first breath will be VC breath, but the ventilator may take 1 to 3 breaths to decide what is the appropriate compliance of the lung, and based on that the pressure control level will be selected, right? Now this pressure control can be high and low depending upon the respiratory system compliance variation from breath to breath. So the tidal volume also will be different. When tidal volume become low, the pressure control will become high. When tidal volume become high, it will become low, right? When the patient receives the volume control breath, the flow will be square, and after that it acquires the flow characteristics of the pressure controlled breath. So it will be a ramp with a pause, right? So now we'll discuss what a very simple algorithm, how the ventilator decides the change in the pressure depending upon the change in the compliance. Let's see. So you provide a test breath. As in here, the first initial breath is a test breath, and from there you measure the tidal volume and compliance, right? Now you compare that to set tidal volume. Now if it is same, that means there is no change in compliance. So the inspiratory pressure remains the same, right? Now if you compare that to set tidal volume, but it comes less means now the compliance has decreased. Because the compliance has decreased, the lung has become stiff, so the tidal volume that is delivered is less. So in this situation, inspiratory pressure will increase, right? If it is more, the tidal volume becomes more, what does that mean? That means compliance has increased, the lung has become more compliant. In that situation, what will happen? The inspiratory pressure will decrease. Now you can see how it is very dynamic to change in the tidal volume or change in the compliance of the lung parenchyma. So this is the advantage of this kind of modes of ventilation, right? This is very, very important. So what are the things that we set? So first is you will set a target tidal volume. Okay, this volume control. So we have to target a tidal volume, but we do not set a target pressure. But this is very important. We set a pressure limit. What does that mean? Pressure limit means the advantage of this mode is it avoids barotrauma. That is the advantage of the PCB. If you do not set a pressure limit to tidal volume, the pressure can jump up beyond the limit that can produce a barotrauma. So we have to set a pressure limit. For example, if we set a pressure limit of 40, then alarm will go at 35. This you have to remember. So the safety limit is 5 millimeter of AC below the limit for pressure that you set, right? So number 3 will be, it's not flow limited. The flow will change depending upon the demand of the patient, or if the patient is sedated or paralyzed, it will depend upon the time constant, which is equal to resistance into compliance. Then we have to set a respiratory rate. That will decide also our I is to E ratio, right? So this is the ventilator parameter that will set. And now here you can see that the inspiratory pressure is variable depending upon the compliance of the lung parenchyma. So in this case, the increase will be in small increments. So increase in pressure control level will be in small increments. It will be around 3 millimeter of mercury up or down, right? In some ventilator, the fast breath can be a pressure control breath, and it will produce a certain tidal volume. From that data, the compliance will be calculated. And once the compliance is calculated, the ventilator will find the inspiratory pressure for the target tidal volume and provide it to the patient, so that we have an adequate tidal volume. At the same time, the pressure will not jump up over a limit that you have set. Plus, advantage will be, it will have the characteristics flow of a pressure control breath. What are the characteristics flow of a pressure control breath? These are not limited. It produces a high mean airway pressure. It can change depending upon the demand or change in resistance or compliance of the system, right? So it can be produced by both when the first breath will be a volume control breath or first breath will be a pressure control breath. In both the situation, the latter part of the breath will be pressure control breath. Those who have the flow characteristics, the pressure characteristics of a pressure control breath. And we have all this advantage over there. And because it is volume targeted, we'll have a good guaranteed mid ventilation. So it gives us the advantage of both VCB and PCB at the same time. So it is considered as an adaptive mode of ventilation, right? But the only disadvantage will be when patient starts breathing, the respiratory rate increases, the tidal volume increases. At that time, the work of breathing is actually very high. But the ventilator may think that the lung compliance has actually increased. So it will decrease the support and it can further increase the work of breathing of the patient. So you have to be very careful and look at the patient's clinical characteristics, what actually is happening in that patient. Otherwise, it is a very good mode to put a patient in. And it is indicated mostly in moderate to severe lung disease with an unstable lung mechanics, unstable resistance and compliance of the lung parenchyma. Right. Thank you very much.